Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making an Irish potato casserole. Potatoes are on almost every American table almost every day. It's really a favorite food. And this is just a tribute that I'm doing to the Irish potato. I'm using potatoes here that happen to be my favorite type of potato, and it's a russet. So you can just choose your favorite type of potato for this casserole. Now, I want to show you how I'm going to prepare these. They're partially prepared because I did cook them after peeling them, and I cooked them until they were fork tender, maybe a little less than fork tender, because I didn't want them to fall apart. Then I refrigerated them, and they've been chilling for about 4 hours or so, at least 4 hours. And now I'm going to grate them. And to explain to you what it's going to be like, I'm just taking this hand grater, and you can see it has some different options as to sizes that I could use. I think the one that's going to work well, and I've done a little bit here just to check, is this one. And I can just do like that and come up with grated Irish potatoes. So I'll be putting those in my casserole, and when I come back, I'll have all of them grated. Here we have 6 grated potatoes. And if you don't have a grater like I had, of course you can use a food processor. That's just a little bit of trouble to clean up. If you don't have anything of that nature to make grated potatoes, then you can just take a knife and cube this into small cubes after you have cooked the potatoes. It will be fine. So we're going to let this sit while we prepare a sauce to go with it. I have 1/2 stick of butter right here. So that's 1/4 cup of butter, and I've melted it because I'm going to take it to the stove along with 2 cups of shredded cheddar cheese. And I'm just going to melt that, and I'll be right back to put some more ingredients in with it. Now you just want to get your shredded cheddar cheese to the point where it's beginning to melt and it's mixing in with the melted butter. Then you're going to add 1 pint or 2 cups, 16 ounces of sour cream. That's 1 carton of sour cream that is pint size. I'm going to also add 1/3 cup of sliced green onion tops. Next, we have 1 teaspoon of salt. I did not salt the potatoes as I was cooking them. If you want to salt them at that point, then you won't need to add this, but I need to add 1 teaspoon of salt for those 6 potatoes. Now I'm adding ground pepper in the form of white ground pepper, and that is 1/4 teaspoon. So we'll stir this all together gently. You see how luscious this sauce looks? Now we're going to pour that over our potatoes. And the potatoes are quite fragile. So you want to pour this over and then gently fold it in. Now we gently fold the sauce into the potatoes. Then choose a casserole dish such as this one and transfer. This is a 2-quart baking dish, and we want to spread out the mixture evenly, smoothing down the top. Now we're going to put a little topping on our casserole, and that is melted butter. If you prefer, you can keep the butter solid and just dot it with butter over the top. But I think it's easier just to melt 2 tablespoons of butter and then just try to cover it fairly evenly. Doesn't have to be perfect. You can kind of let it wander from one place to another. Now this goes to a 350 degree oven, and it's probably going to take 30 minutes to 45 minutes. So I'll watch the time for you and let you know. Our Irish potato casserole is done, and it took approximately 45 minutes in a 350 degree oven. Here's what we have. Now everything was cooked and edible when we put this in the oven, but it's just a matter of getting all of those flavors combined and getting the potato casserole to be nice and crusty around the edges and top. So I'm going to take a little bit of this on my plate, and I'll test it for you and let you see what it's like. You might want to look at it as I cut down into it. You can see the texture that it has. Just almost spill some. still has some butter on the top. If you want to use less butter, you might. Here I have my Irish potato casserole, and it's very hot. You might be able to see that it's still steaming. I just dipped it onto this plate, and I'm going to take a fork, and you know I'm going to go for some of the crusty part right here. And that's nice and cheesy, and get some of the potato part, and there will be a little bit of green onion in there, and sour cream, of course. Mmm. I love potatoes. This is a great combination. If you really like things like stuffed baked potatoes or trice baked potatoes, where there is a mixture of things like sour cream and butter and cheese, green onions, along with the potato, you know how good it tastes. And this recipe really is easy to do. And doesn't require a lot of ingredients and not really expensive. I guess the cheddar cheese would be the most expensive part. You could cut down on that if you wanted to. I think you'll enjoy making it, and I hope you enjoy the recipe.